Hello and welcome to the channel Automation Step by Step. Today is Friday, so let us begin our QnA Friday episode. And today we are taking up a question asked by Asim, and he says, "Hope you are doing good, and I must say you are doing a fabulous job, especially for people who are new to automation. I have not thoroughly checked your videos, therefore I am sorry in advance if I am asking a redundant question. I am looking for guidance about test automation engineer career growth and related skill set. For example, if someone want to apply for a test automation engineer for first time, what minimal skill set he should have, and certainly from there on grow from there. I know it's ever changing list, but at least it will be good starting point for people who has background of manual testing but having difficulty in changing their fields from manual tester to automation engineer." Asim, thank you so much for asking this question. And the skill set for test automation engineer, or the minimal skill set required for creating your career as test automation engineer, can vary from organization to organization. For example, in some organizations, they are very deeply into UI, so they need mostly UI automation testing and not any other kinds of testing. Then there are other organizations you will find they are heavily into API development and they need API testing and not UI and other kinds of testing. Then you will find some organizations who need a mix and match of UI, API, mobile, even desktop and database testing. So these skill set can vary from organization to organization. And also there are some organizations who hire freshers and then they train them and groom them according to their requirements. But to answer your query on a generic minimal skill set required for starting your career as test automation engineer, I will give you suggestion for learning three basic tools. The first one is for UI automation. The second one is a performance testing tool. And the third one will be a CI automation or CI/CD tool. Now, coming to the first UI automation, you can go with Selenium. Selenium is open source, free and widely used. And you will find lots and lots of free information and tutorials online. The second one for performance testing, you can go with JMeter. JMeter again is open source, very widely used and very easy to learn. And the third one for continuous integration and continuous integration automation, you can go with Jenkins. Jenkins again is open source, very widely used and easy to learn. In the description of this video, I will provide you three links. First one for Selenium, then for JMeter, and then for Jenkins from my channel, from where you can learn from scratch. So you can learn step by step from basics and learn all these three tools. And also you will find lots of other information online on these tools. Now, in case you have even more time and in case you want to really stand out, if you can learn a tool for or a library for API automation and an open source library or tool for mobile automation, for example, for mobile, you can go with APM, and for API, you can go with maybe SOAP UI open source version, Rest Assured or Postman. If you can learn some basics, that will really add to your skill set and really make you stand out. But these are optional. In case you have some extra time, you can go with it. But if you have a knowledge of one UI, one performance and one CI tool, even the basic knowledge will be sufficient to start your career. And then of course you learn a lot in the job. So whatever organization you are with, you will find lots and lots of opportunity to learn on the job and then even add to your skill set. So that was all in today's episode of Q&A Friday. In case you want to feature your question in the next episode, you can send me your query at ask.qnafriday@gmail.com. I will meet you in the next session. Thank you for watching.